good day, dear viewers. Today we have a great person in our studio, Excellency Mr. Martin Kobler, who, due to his pro-environment tweets and his activities on social media, perhaps needs no introduction in Pakistan. He has a huge fan in Pakistan on social media, and he keeps on tweeting very pertinent tweets. And of course, I can say that he's portraying a positive image of Pakistan through his social media post and through his tweets. So thank you very much, Excellency, for being here. So today in follow-up, we'll just discuss the future dimensions of bilateral relations with German government and with Germany and Pakistan. And of course, after a successful political transition in Pakistan, the new government is trying to somehow correct the perception of Pakistan overseas. And I just wanted to take your take on it. So when you go back to Germany, do you feel some positivity coming for Pakistan in general masses due to this current political transition?
Now, I think this is now really the period to use this window of opportunity with the Naya Pakistan, with the government formation process. But we also had a difficult year in Germany. We did not have so many visitors here because there was also difficulties in government formation, but 2019 should now really be a kickstart. I think I see some movement here, but I must say very clearly, I'm not happy. I'm not happy with the state of bilateral economic relations. You see, I mean, 2.8 billion US dollars in trade exchange is really, compared to the potential both Germany and Pakistan have, it's, well, frankly speaking, a joke. I mean, there is still a lot to improve. And also 300 million investment in this country is also something I, as German ambassador, cannot be happy with. That's why I, at the beginning of my stay here, I still sensed a certain reluctance of German companies whenever it came to Pakistan, because of course we have a great investment, bigger investment in India. Now, that's why I always invite German companies to come and to have a look. And then they said, no, there are security problems, whatever. And I try, as you say, to correct the image a little bit, because security is definitely better than it was in 2008. I mean, we are 10 years after 2008 and things are permanently improving. That's why I took the initiative to go to the Gulf, to Dubai, to see the regional directors of German companies and to invite them to come here. What we need is a German-Pakistani Chamber of Commerce linked to the global network of German chambers of commerce. And I think this is the way to go. I will again go to the Gulf, to Dubai, to meet them, together now with the new team of the Pakistani Board of Investment, in order to inject a little bit more confidence into them. I see a movement, I see a positive movement, that the German companies are much more interested than they have been two, three.
Thank you, Excellency. And you know, when it comes to import-export, the bilateral trade, as you rightly mentioned, do you see some potential in Pakistani products that we are not able to market properly in Europe in general, and particularly in Germany?
Well, export for Pakistan is of course very important because you are importing a lot and much more. So you have a $25-30 billion gap here. Now, the question is whether we have now Heimtextil. This is a fair in Germany because textile is one of the most important export products for Pakistan. And Heimtextil and the textile sector is very important. However, I doubt whether to continue the textile export in this way to produce cheap t-shirts for selling in Germany, whether this is as a future. Why not having higher end textile? design aware, right? Because there is a market in Europe for this.
And the GSP Plus as well.
And the GSP Plus. So in order to get away from this mass production more, as other countries do, as Bangladesh is doing increasingly, as other textile producing countries are doing it, to have more high-end textile. Because you have such great designers here in the country. I have seen in Lahore, the Institute for Fashion and Design. I mean, you can compete with Rome, with Paris, and with other countries. So why not going more into this direction to have this high-end textile? And the other thing is on the technical field, technical products. I was in Sialkot, I mean, the surgical instruments. You proved very well that you are in a position to produce the footballs for the World Championship. And other very powerful and big countries could not do it, but you could do it. Why don't you go more into the innovative factor?
Value addition and innovation.
IT is another question. There are so many, you see, my son is working in an IT company and they have their counterpart in Nepal. So they are working in the mornings, the other working in the afternoons. Yeah. So it's a kind of joint venture with a Nepali IT company. And this can be done here in Pakistan also. And there are many, many innovative sectors, I mean, Pakistan can also earn money with.
Well, thank you for giving these examples. I think one more aspect that I wanted to discuss, in Pakistan, we are impatiently waiting to hear some good news about Volkswagen. Is there any progress on it?
Well, Volkswagen took the decision to have a production plant here. I'm very happy. But as you know, the Japanese market here is very strong. But it's good Volkswagen took this decision. Volkswagen is present in India. Volkswagen will be present here with the production. And I'm looking forward to
it. So will they be going for these small cars or will they be going for trucks?
Well, they are going for utility cars, but also with a small car. And I'm very much looking forward for it because Pakistan has a growing middle class for the small cars. And the market will decide whether they will be able to compete. Now, I'm very happy that this, well, meager kind of state of our byland of German investments here, that this will
And of course, we hope grow. There would be more environment-friendly engines and environment-friendly technology in those automobiles.
Indeed. I mean, this
compared
is the,
to what we are using right
trend.
Now.
What we are doing in Germany is now we are doing a lot of research on e-cars, on electromobiles, in order to reduce the emissions from the cars. I think that's very important.
And finally, we know British Airways, they have resumed their operation. They are about to resume their operations in June. Can we hear any such news from Lufthansa as well?
Well, that's a great move of British Airways, and I hope it encourages also other Western airlines to come to Pakistan. I have been advocating the resumption of the direct flights who were suspended because of security reasons way back in 2008 with Lufthansa. So it was not possible so far. As you know, Lufthansa is a private company, so the government cannot say, listen, Lufthansa, fly to Lahore or fly to Islamabad. But what I'm doing from the political side, I have contact with Lufthansa. I'm constantly asking them and urging them at least to consider to send a mission to also in the security field to revise the security situation and to have an own impression. I'm very confident now British Airways is here, also other Western airlines, including Lufthansa, they might reconsider their suspension and send people in order to do some fact-finding here, how to resume flights.
And finally, there is quite a big following ship of Deutsche Welle. Of course, it's available on many cable channels and others. But you might have seen that there are certain other Western channels who are producing their program in Urdu, and they have contracted with the local channels, half an hour, 40-minute slot by BBC, by CNN, and by many others. So is there any plan by which Deutsche Welle, they can actually air some of their contents on the TV channels available in Urdu for...
No, I'm not aware of any plan, but this is a very good idea. So I take it with me from this interview and I discuss it with Deutsche Welle. Deutsche Welle for us is a big asset.
Yes, it is.
And this is very
good. Objective reporting.
Yes, it's objective reporting. So many in a well, environment of private TV stations and private radio stations. They rely also on foreign reporting because they think they are also or a little bit more reliable maybe. They report in a different way. It would be great. It's a great idea. I mean to team up with a local station here.
Thank you very much, Excellency.
Thank you. It was a pleasure to be here. Thank you.